there, I'm Miss Raquel from the Scenester channel, and we're outside a pop nightclub down here in Toronto, Ontario, and we are about to interview and dig into the mind of the Scumfrog. Now, he has had numerous number one hits throughout the US, the UK, and of course, we love him here in Canada. And of course, he's most notable for his performances because he has samples, he does live percussions, you name it, this cat drops it. So let's dig into the mind of the Scumfrog. Let's get inside.
My name is Paul. I love coming to see Scumfrog because I love his track, Another Fucking Love Song. And he's so amazing, and this is why I'm here.
How's it going, Scenester fans? Sam from Toronto, and we're here at Pop on Richmond Street to see the Scumfrog. Too bad you guys aren't here. It's going to be good times.
Hi, this is Joelle from Toronto. Scenester rocks, and so does Scumfrog, and he puts on one of the best shows ever.
We were coming into the club, and here we are. We are with none other than the Scumfrog.
Hello.
How are you doing? Welcome.
I'm good. Thank you for having me.
So, you know, one thing I do have to ask you, and I think what a lot of people want to know, is let's just talk about the name. Where did the Scumfrog come from?
I lost a bet.
You lost a bet. Can I ask, or should we dare?
No, actually, the real answer is very boring. A friend of mine from Amsterdam, where I'm from originally, he read Scumfrog in something that did not say Scumfrog at all, and it was very funny at the time, so it became my nickname. And then we needed to make records, and we needed to have aliases, so it became one of the aliases, and that's how it grew.
And I just have to say on your website, and people, you can visit his website, it's, you have Scumberry. It's like a blackberry, but it says Scumberry. That's just like so cool. Was that your idea?
Yes, it was, actually. It was my idea.
And are you a berry guy or are you an iPhone guy?
I'm a berry guy.
You're a berry guy.
Yeah,
okay.
Absolutely.
So then out of all of these productions you've had, I mean, you've had many numerous number one hits. You know, which one would you say you're most proud of? Or can you even say one? I know that's a difficult question.
Oh, by far the stuff with Cyndi Lauper. Absolutely. Because, first of all, I grew up on her. I don't want to give her age away, but it was absolutely amazing to work with her. And she brought so much to the table that was new to me, because up until that point I had worked with other artists, but they kind of came in and they were like, okay, we're going to now sing on a Scumfrog production. So most artists that I had worked with, they kind of gave me the rein and, you know, gave me all the decision making process, whereas with Cyndi I took the back seat and it was her thing, but at the same time it was all electronic, so that was all my, so it was a true collaboration, and that was a whole revelation for me. So yeah, that's what I'm most proud of.
Well, she's fantastic. We interviewed her for Scenester magazine, and she is just, she's one fantastic artist, and I grew up with her too. Well, thank you, Scumfrog. We appreciate you visiting us here at Scenester channel, and we definitely look forward to your set. Now tell people where they can find you, and of course buy your music and all that good stuff.
thescumfrog.com.
Yes. Well, thank you so much, and thank you for watching the Scenester channel.
And now, kids, you too may learn the dance.